So right now in our project plan, you'll see that our current date is here in red, representing where we are today. We talked about our blue line representing our project date, and the importance of this current date is that it really is a date and a line that we can look at to tell us where we should be based on where this line falls in conjunction to where our tasks are. And right now, everything is to the right of our project plan and therefore is still in the future and therefore to be done. And things to the left of your current date are really in the past and therefore should be done. So it's a really good tool to use to determine where you should be versus where you are. And one of the things that I'm going to do just for this class, this red line, by the way, moves all by itself. So as you progress along your project plan, that current date's going to move all by itself. But I'm going to force it to move right now and pretend that some time has gone by. In fact, I'm going to pretend that it's now the end or the middle of November. So I'm going to go to Project and select my Project Information dialog box. And remember, we talked about this early on in the program. And here's our current date. So I'm going to fast forward our current date to be sometime in the middle of November, say November 14th. And I'm going to select OK. Notice that I now have moved my red line out to the future. And I did this because I want to illustrate how you update and track in Project. So at some point, maybe it's weekly, maybe it's every 2 weeks, maybe it's daily, maybe it's monthly, or even quarterly, depending on the nature of your project, you're going to want to keep the project plan up to date. You certainly don't want to wait to the end of your project to record what actually happened. You want to use this as a management tool going forward. So what you want to do is come in here and update probably at a decent frequency level that's relevant to your project. So if you're working on a very tight time frame and you're in the thick of your project planning, you might be doing this on a daily basis. Typically, you might do it once a week. I would suggest that that could be your guideline. Go in here and update your project plan once a week. And based on the techniques that I'm going to show you, it's really not a lot to do. And the benefit that you'll get back is incredible. It might be once a month or it might be quarterly, but this current date is really an indicator of where you are now and everything to the left. So all these tasks should be done or they need to be rescheduled. And everything to the right is still in the future, unless some of it's already done, which means that you need to reschedule it as well. And we're going to talk about some of those updating strategies. Notice under Project Information, there's also a status date that you can use outside of your current date. So you can update to the status date or you can update to the current date, either one. And that status date can also be applied. So you really have two dates. So you might actually put a status date that's different than your current date because you might be getting ready for something in the future or you might be getting ready for something that has already occurred. So you might be, as of last Friday, I want to update my project plan because that's all the information I have. So you can actually have a status date different than your current date. So you have those two options available to you in Microsoft Project to update to either the status date or the current date. And we'll talk about how to do that automatically in the next section. In this section, I just wanted to show you where that current date is kept and how you can fast forward it. And we just did that, keeping in mind that this red line moves all by itself as time progresses along your project. And every time you open up your project plan, it'll be further to the right. And that is the date that you want to use to quickly eyeball your plan and help you update and track the activities on your project plan. So that's what I wanted to cover in this section. It's just quick and easy understanding and viewing the current date. Let's now get into entering in percent completes and how you do that in Microsoft Project in the very next section.